Cameron, an excellent win from Durham, your highest score against Warwickshire in a T20 here, and your first win against them in six attempts as well.
Yeah, there you go. Didn't know that. I thought it was a pretty good performance today. I thought we probably got about 20 over par. I reckon it was actually a really tough wicket when you hit the pitch, bowl change-ups, they did that quite well. And then we executed quite well with the ball. So, any win you take in this competition and any bit of momentum you can keep bringing with your team, it's important. So, it's going well.
And as you mentioned, 20 over par, that's exactly what one of the lads from the BBC in the Midlands has just said at the end of our commentary there. It did look quite a scratchy surface initially, didn't it? And a difficult surface to get the ball away on.
Yeah, it was a bit of a different game. It wasn't like there was lots of fours and sixes, and obviously the boundaries are quite big here, so running twos was a big part of the game. For both sides, you had to run twos. It was difficult to defend, so I guess it was a different kind of game of cricket in the end. I think it's a part of the ground here, our home ground. It's where I would have big boundaries, and it's kind of how the game needs to be played at times, especially when you're playing on one of the middle tracks and both sides are quite big.
Yeah, and your 10th half century, I think, in T20, and your first for Durham as well. That must have been nice to get one in a Durham shirt today.
Yeah, absolutely. You always want to try and contribute to the team, and it was nice to be able to be involved in a couple of partnerships out there to get us up to a decent score. So, very pleasing.
I presume, I can't remember that you've ever played with Ben Stokes. In fact, maybe the first time you met him was in the Ashes series in 2019. I don't think he was at Durham that year. So what was it like to have him back in the team today? Because he brings a whole new world with him, doesn't he, in cricket?
Not a bad in, Ben Stokes. it was awesome. He was awesome out there. He brings great energy. He loves putting on the Durham shirt, and you can just feel that. And clearly, no matter what team he's playing for, he's just so passionate and committed to playing each game. And today was no different. It was awesome fun. I know the boys really enjoyed it, and hopefully he can stick around for a little bit longer.
Did he mention his past history with Carlos Brathwaite? It was ironic that it was Brathwaite who got him when Durham were batting, and then Ben got his revenge when he took the catch to get Brathwaite out when the Bears were batting.
Yeah, exactly. A little bit of competition there. Always brings a little bit of fun, but it was nice he got the upper hand in the end.
And you bowled well as well, didn't you? I mean, it's a very dry pitch. We haven't had any rain for weeks now. It's rock hard, the surface. Ball can easily go to the boundary, but you controlled it well. And Bryden Carr with career best figures as well, 3 wickets for him today.
Yeah, I thought he bowled really well. Birmingham came hard at us at times during the game, and I thought we held our nerve quite well, picked up wickets at the right times, and just able to find a way to get the job done. So that's the main thing at the end of the day.
And finally, despite all the issues behind the scenes with the coronavirus and the second team squad having to isolate, I mean, it's actually going well for the first team, isn't it? You're threadbare, but the results are still coming your way.
Yeah, we've been challenged at the moment, but I guess there's nothing we can really do about it but just crack on and do the best you can. So I guess we're quite fortunate that the first team haven't been able to be in contact with our staff member that was unfortunately contracted it, but we're just being challenged and we're just finding a way to do our best. So that's all you can ask for.
Just a call from me, that's okay.
Yeah.
You had a very good start of late in the power play. Be impressed with how able batting was able to adapt to not quite getting that fast out this time.
Yeah, I think that was that's something we've spoken about in the last sort of few games. Top order started the game off really well. We've probably just been a bit scratchy through the middle, whereas today was probably a little bit different. We had to do a bit more lifting in the middle, and we're able to do that. So it's good that we're talking about those things and finding a way to try and implement them in games. But you just got to try and be as adaptable as possible, and that's kind of what the game presented today.
Yourself, you got that 29 the other night. Did that really help settle some nerves today, so you can build on that and build it and take into this game?
Yeah, look, at the end of the day, I felt like I'd been hitting the ball really well. Just found a couple of random ways to get out. It's nice the last two games to be able to get some runs out there, contribute to the team score. So it's nice. Hopefully I can keep going.
Thank you. four wins out of six, it's quite tight at the top. How key is it to keep on building this momentum?
Yeah, huge. Huge. You know, the games come thick and fast, so if you keep winning, you know, that can become a little bit of a habit, I think. You know, if you keep winning games. So, yeah, look, we've played some good cricket so far, and hopefully we can keep it up.